What's up, guys? Hi, and welcome to Uncle Scott's Kitchen. What we're going to do today is help people who are new to carbon steel. We're going to go through five big mistakes that people often make when they get their first carbon steel pan or skillet and give some tips on how to fix those mistakes. Now, as most people probably know, when you buy a new carbon steel skillet, when it arrives, it is shiny and silvery. And then after you season them and cooking them about a zillion times, they kind of turn shiny and dark, almost jet black. The first mistake that people make with their carbon steel skillets is thinking that on day one, that this skillet has to be turned into this skillet. It does not have to work like that. Now, there's been some popular TV shows, there's some videos on the internet, it's even been in magazines, where people get these carbon steel skillets and they go through multiple seasoning steps. They season these things over and over and over. If you add up the time and effort that goes into these original initial seasonings, according to those methods, you can be working on one of these pans. Granted, it's not physical labor, but you can have 16, 18 hours of your oven tied up just to get a pan seasoned and ready to cook for the first time. I'm here to tell you, you don't have to do that. You can season your pan one time, correctly of course, but just season your pan one time and just start cooking. I think that works better. I think the time that you would have spent worrying about the seasoning is much better going into learning how to cook delicious food in your new pan. Now, after that first seasoning, you will notice that your pan might still be shiny, it might still be silvery, could be blotchy, could have patches of yellow, could have patches of brown. That's all okay because you're new in your pan, you're starting to use your pan. It will darken in over time. So what we want to do is worry about our seasoning this much and our cooking this much. Develop your cooking skills. That time you would have spent, all those seasoning steps will be better spent if you just use your pan. Cook, cook, cook more and season less. Mistake number two is early on, people often use too much oil when they season their pans. Here, when it comes to seasoning a carbon steel skillet, less is more. So we always say use a thin coat of oil and the seasoning will build up over time. People try to skip steps and use too much oil. It does not work that way. It's kind of like putting salt on scrambled eggs. A little bit of salt makes the eggs better. If you put an entire shaker full of salt on there, you have ruined your breakfast. You've ruined the eggs. It's kind of the same with carbon steel. For a pan, for example, like this 11 7/8 inch matfer, really love this pan. If I were going to season that pan in my oven, what I would want to do is take about 1/8 of a teaspoon of oil, just a few drops. Put that in the pan, wipe it all around with paper towels. You'll notice that you can see some streaks of oil. It will be shiny. You can see little bitty micro droplets. What you want to do is get some more paper towels, wipe it out again until it looks almost dry, and then you can season this thing in the oven. If you see streaks, if you see drops, if you see drips or runs, you have way, way, way too much oil on that pan. It will get sticky when you try to season it, and you don't want that. And the problem is kind of sort of similar when you use your stovetop. On the stovetop, we put 1 millimeter of oil in the bottom of the pan. We make sure the sides are coated, and we bring that oil up to its smoke point. Then we pour that oil out, either into a bowl or a soup can. You got to be very careful when you do it. You're going to have a searing hot pan with smoking oil. So it's a little bit more dangerous on the stovetop, just be careful. But what people do here is they don't wipe the pan out after they pour out that oil. Like the pan we put in the oven, we have to take a big wad of paper towels. Use a big wad here and make sure they are between your fingers in the searing hot pan. And again, wipe this pan until it looks dry. If you don't wipe it out, if you leave oil in there that you can see beading up, when the pan cools, it's gonna get sticky. Mistake number three, using the wrong oil to season your pan early on. Now, here are your three choices that I would go with for seasoning a carbon steel skillet when you're new. First, is veggie. You can also use canola, or you can use grapeseed. I have really good luck with grapeseed. Choose one of those three oils and you will eliminate one potential headache. Now, someone always says, and they ask me, can I use ghee? Nope. Can you use flax? Nope. Olive oil? Nope. Refined coconut oil? Nope. Beef tallow? Nope. You want to use grapeseed, vegetable, or canola. Use one of those three when you're getting started and you will eliminate one headache. Mistake number four, and this is a biggie and a really important one, is people cook foods at the wrong temperature. So you got your nice new carbon steel skillet, you've seasoned it, you got the correct amount of oil on there, you use the correct oil to season it with, you start cooking and stuff sticks. What is going on? Is there something wrong with the pan? Is there something wrong with the seasoning? 9 times out of 10 here, you're just cooking food at the wrong temperature. And this often happens because people move to carbon steel from, say, a chemical coated non-stick skillet. Nobody ever tells you that when you do that, you have to change your cooking methods a little bit. You actually have to learn a few skills. Not that big of a deal. We like learning new cooking and kitchen skills around here anyway. It's just that nobody ever tells you that you need to do it. So you start cooking in carbon steel, things aren't going right. You tend to blame the pan. You tend to blame the seasoning. Really, 9 times out of 10, I'm making that up. But most times, the problem is just you're cooking at the wrong temperature. And this can be either too high or too low. Between too high and too low, there is a sweet spot where most of your food is not going to stick. And the way you find that sweet spot is you just practice a little bit. That's why I say don't spend all this time on your seasoning early on. Cook, cook, cook more and season less. Now you can do it each time you cook. That will be a little bit longer process. If you want to speed up learning about your pan, try the dozen egg challenge. Take $5 or so. Hyperinflation, hopefully you can get a dozen eggs for $5 these days. Take $5, buy a dozen eggs, cook those eggs one after the other, move your pan around to different eyes, try different temperature settings. Somewhere around egg number 7, the light bulb is gonna go off. You'll get your pan dialed in, figure out how to cook in it. Like everything else in life, a little bit of practice goes a long way. Cook more and season less. Number 5, this one used to drive me crazy. It's adding your protective oil at the wrong time and screwing up your seasoning. Now, let's say you got your pan dialed in, you do some cooking, the food is nonstick, you have a nice meal, you wash your pan in hot water, you don't use any soap, you dry it with a dish towel, and then what does everybody say? Put it on a burner, 30, 45 seconds, evaporate that remaining moisture off of there so you don't get any rust. And then everybody says, add a couple of drops of oil, wipe it around as a protective layer. It will protect the pan from any rust between now and the next time you're going to use it. Well, what I used to do and what used to drive me crazy is my pan would be perfect. I would go through all that, I would add my oil, wipe it all around, and I would come back later, the pan was sticky. What was happening is I was not letting the pan cool down after I had dried it on the stovetop. So if you take a moderately hot pan, put oil in there, put your protective oil in there and wipe it around, it's gonna get sticky. What you're doing is essentially doing a halfway seasoning. You're not getting that oil up to its smoking point. It's not gonna bond to anything. It's just gonna get gunky and sticky. So your pan can be perfect. You wash it, you clean it, you dry it, you add your protective oil and you gunk it up. Make sure that pan is back down to room temperature before you add your protective oil. Okay, look somewhere on the screen for links to more carbon steel videos you might find helpful and enjoyable. We're always around here at Uncle Scott's Kitchen to help with carbon steel. It's how this whole channel got started. Post your questions, comments, your problems below. I'll see if I can answer those. Thank you for watching. We'll see you again next time on Uncle Scott's Kitchen.